नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। डियर चिल्ड्रन, कंटिन्यू ऑफ बेसिक फीचर्स ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, आवर एट टॉपिक इज अमेंडमेंट इन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। नाउ डियर चिल्ड्रन, व्हाट वाज द मीनिंग ऑफ द अमेंडमेंट? अमेंडमेंट इट मीन्स द चेंज ऑफ। Compared to the other country, constitution of India is a dynamic. Dear children, what they have to given then? They have to given that compared with the other country of constitution, our constitution of India is a dynamic. Dynamic, it means gatishil, kriyashil, it means as per the time our constitution of India is changes. Constitution can be amendment as and when is required. What they have to given that our constitution can be amendment. Amendment it means sudhara, changes, as per its requirement. Constitutional provision can be amendment into three way. It means the following they have to given the three way where the amendment is done into the our constitution. First, amendment can be made by a simple majority of member present and voting in the parliament. One way is that amendment can be made by a simple majority, through which, through the simple majority of the members present and voting in the parliament. This is the first way when we can amendment in our constitution. Second one, certain amendment is require a special majority. Wherever, what they have to say that? They have to say that the certain amendment required a special majority. In this special majority, 2/3 of the majority of the member are present and voting. That time they have to change in our amendment of the constitution. Third one, concerning the union and state relation, the special majority, that 2/3 and the concern not less than 50% of state legislative is required. What they have to say that? They have to say that whenever concerned with the union and state relation, that requires the 2/3 part of the majority, and also there is not present less than 50% of the state legislative. It means the more than 50% are required present people in state legislative. If there is any amendment to be made in the interrelation between union and state structure of or in supreme judiciary, what they have to say that? They have to say that it is required the interrelationship between the union and state structure, and they all are working under the supreme judiciary. Then half of the state from the total state have to give their consent. Judgment of the court can also bring the amendment by the parliament. What they have to say that? They have to say that whatever the judgment given by the court is given also the amendment by the parliament. There will be no change in the basic structure of the constitution. This is the most important thing, dear children. What? There will be no change in the basic structure of the constitution. Simple majority in parliament can bring the changes in the amendment of the constitution. What they have to say that? They have to say that if is any party have simple majority in the parliament, that's why they have to change, it means they have to amendment the constitution. But here we things they have to require, these things is required there. Here they, any party will not change the basic structure of the constitution, and that's why the constitution is known as the most inconsistent and flexible document. And that's why what we can say that? We can say that the constitution is known as the most inconsistent. Inconsistent it means the unnisthit and flexible parivartanshak document. But at certain cases it is not amendable by the simple majority. That's why this constitution can not amendable by the simple majority. Without the majority consent of the state, it is not amendable. And then to the mixture of both make the constitution, and that's why they have to require the mixing of the both the constitution are required. Next one is the universal adult suffrage, and you know very well that adult it means book, suffrage it means the matadhikara. Now, universal adult suffrage. In India, we have a system of adult suffrage which is the flexible. What happened there? In India, we have a system of adult suffrage which is the flexible. According to that, any citizen who is above the 18 year of age, dear children, this is the most important thing. Any citizen who is above 18 year of age and above the possess right to vote in the election of the parliament, legislative assembly or local self-government body without any discrimination of education, property and economic standard. Here what they have to given that? They have to given that here any person whose age is more than 18 year or 18 year, this person is without any kind of the discrimination on the basis of education, property, economic standard, the person is eligible to give the right to vote in the any election of the parliament. Next one they have to given about the secularism. Which one? Secularism. We have discussed the earlier about the secularism in the preamble. Dear children, we have already learned and discussed about the secularism in our preamble. And we know very well that secularism, it means bin sampradayikta. In the constitution, India has been declared as a secular state. So, as per our Indian constitution, we know very well that India has been declared as a secular state. People of the different religion reside in India. It means the people of the different religion reside in India. It means the all religious people are living in India. Hindu, Muslim, Sikh and Isai. And that's why we can say that India is unity in diversity. Therefore, the state cannot discriminate any citizen on the basis of religion. It means the any state cannot doing the any kind of the discrimination. Discrimination yani bhedbha of any citizen on basis of their religion. No citizen can be given the special right or cannot be deprived with certain rights. It means no any particular citizen can given the special right or even cannot be deprived. Deprived it means vanchit rakhna, chhin lena with certain rights. The state has to be absolutely impartial and neutral in respect of the religion. It means the state is not doing the any kind of the partiality with the anyone on the basis of the religion. Only secular state can offer the proper or equal treatment towards the all the citizen. It means it is requirement that you to given the equal as well as the proper treatment to all the citizen. Secularism means that the state does not interfere in the matter of the religion. What was the meaning of the secularism? Secularism, it means that the state doesn't interfere in the matter of the religion or is biased to any specific religious. The state has to be secular and indifferent. That's why we can say the state has to be a secular as well as indifferent. Followers of every religion are free to follow any, practice the religions of choice. What they have to say that, dear children, they have to say that follower of every religion can free to follow the any religious by his or her choice. Next one they have to given about the judicial review. Judicial review is the chief characteristic of the constitution. Judicial review is one kind of the chief characteristic of our constitution. Judicial review administer the working of the union and state within the jurisdiction. What the judicial review has stated? That judicial review has stated that all kind of the administration work are work under the union and state within the jurisdiction without the disrespecting the power of the parliament. It means you have to work without any kind of the disrespecting of the power of the parliament. The constitution has made an effort to harmonize the principle. It means the constitution has also done the efforts regarding with the harmonize the principle. Harmonize it means ek sutrata, it means the unity of the judicial review. Parliamentary amendment, external order, ordinance, judicially judgment are given for the judicial review. It means this all above given things which are parliamentary amendment, external order, ordinance, judicially judgment, this all are given under the judicial review. If the court find the any indiscriminacy in the external order, ordinance or the judicial judgment, it can stop by declaring them as unconstitutional. It means what happened that any kind of the order is done on the basis of the external and ordinance or the judicial judgment can be stopped by declaring them as unconstitutional. It means each and everyone has followed the constitution. Next, they have to given about the fundamental rights and duty. Fundamental rights are conferred to the people of India by constitution to live and dignified life. It means the whatever the fundamental rights are given to the people, these fundamental rights are the people of the India by constitution given to live as well as the dignified life. What was the meaning of dignified? Dignified, it means the pratishthita. The most valuable capital of our country is in the overall development of the nation. What was the main aim of our nation? The main aim of our nation, that the most valuable capital of our country is the overall development of our nation. This is the main aim of the, our fundamental rights and duties are given as per the, our constitution, which further lies in the fundamental duties and rights. Right to constitutional remedies and for the children 6 to 14 years of the age, right to educate are also made available. As per the constitution of India, they have given about the rights to the children, that 6 to 14 years of the children of the age, if the right of the education is also made available. After, they have to given about the 13 point directive principle of the state policy. Protection of people, security and welfare should be carried out by the state. Dear children, what they have to say, that they have to say that the protection of the people, security and the welfare should be carried out by the state. This principle provides the direction for the state governance and policy making, so that they called as a directive principle. It means what happened there, this kind of the principle provide a direction for the state governments and policy making, so that called as a directive principle. So next one, 14th one, last one, they have to given about the provision for backward section and the TRIPS. Which one? Provision of backward section and TRIPS. To uplift and include the backward section and TRIPS and deprived classes in the mainstream. What they have to say, that dear children, they have to say that in our constitution they have also provide a provision for the backward section in the TRIPS for the upliftment of that people. There are the specific provision in the constitution. It means in our constitution they have given the specific provision for the upliftment of the backward section in the TRIPS. Reserved seats are allotted in the legislative and local self-government bodies election to provide the representation. It means the some reserved seats are allocated in legislative and local self-government bodies into the election to provide them as a representative. Reservation quota has been provided for the admission in educational institutes. What they have to say, that dear children, also they have given the reservation quota has been provided for the admission in the educational institution and government job in the proportion to their population. It means their quota was given for the admission in educational institute at village the in government job on the proportion of the population to provide the equal opportunity. Children of the backward section and the TRIPS are given the scholarship. What they have to say, that dear children, the children of the backward TRIPS, it means the children who are from the backward section and the TRIPS are given the scholarship, basic amenities and the waived fees which comes under the optimistic policy. It means the children who came from the backward section as well as from the backward TRIPS have given the scholarship by the government, as well as they have to given so many amenities, it means suvidha, and waived fees. Waived, it means chhoot, tiyar, which come under the optimistic policy. What was the meaning of optimistic? Optimistic, it means the asavadi. And shielding the policy. Shielding, what was the meaning of shielding? Shielding, it means rakshan karna. As per the provision in the constitution, it means as per the provision of the constitution, Our constitution was given the equal opportunity for the backward section and the tribe as per their population. Thank you for joining us.